Brian Brown's son. Brian Brown was, raise your hand, Brian. He works on the Carlos Fierro 5150 team. Race car driver I used to race against. Great, great folks. And so Brian set this up as a little surprise for them. Okay, here's Frank. Red flag. Are you sure you want to do it? It must be a good one, Frank. She's very happy. Good job. Times over the years, actually, Roy Park Sr., a Korean War vet. Roy, raise your hand if you're up there. There he is. Roy played Pat for us. Roy has read things, written things, just a wonderful writer. And so about, I don't know, maybe a month ago, we've been working on a project out here that Roy Park's helping us with. And so he brought this book by and handed it to me. It's called Medal of Honor, Portraits of Valor Beyond Call of Duty. And so I've read the heck out of this thing cover to cover, but I think the most amazing part of this book is the story. It's about a handful of Medal of Honor recipients. It's got a couple of president's signatures and some other really amazing signatures, but the story is the amazing part. So I want to briefly tell the story and then about the individual that owned this book. The story is Roy Park Sr. owns a mini store, and the individual that owned this book was a Medal of Honor recipient. And his son, which was paralyzed, could no longer pay for the mini storage room. So, and oftentimes in mini storage, what they'll do is they'll auction them off. So Roy Hart had no idea what was in this mini storage. He goes over and cuts the locks off. They get it ready for auction. He walks in. He finds all of this military storage of memorabilia. This book was in there. The gentleman's Medal of Honor was in there. So pretty amazing story. The gentleman that owned this book, his name was Robert L. Howard, Sergeant First Class, U.S. Army Special Forces. And just a brief, I'll just give you an overview real quick instead of reading this pretty amazing read it. But went in the Army in 1956. 1965, he was shot in the face in Vietnam. Ended up in the hospital. While in the hospital, a sergeant came in from a special forces unit, noticed his size and his story, and basically recruited him to join special forces. He was in 1968 in Vietnam. He had already been recommended for two Medals of Honor. December 28, 1968, he was with his platoon and they went to rescue a Green Beret that was trapped. They ended up in a three-day firefight. He ends up, a grenade blew him up and he was shot multiple times. The enemy was, it's described in here, it's pretty amazing, but the smell of burning skin and bodies. They used flamethrowers and they were hiding and burning them up. He ends up dragging his lieutenant out, saves him, and in 1971, received the Medal of Honor. Well, that Medal of Honor is in Roy Hart's mini storage. It's been there for a year. Roy Hart went and just walked it up. Didn't auction it, contacted the family, what he intends to do. We may get a chance to interview Roy, but basically take it, whether it's Legion Halls or museums or whatnot, put all of this in there. But from the way he told the story is pretty amazing. He basically sat in that mini storage and read this book cover to cover. I'm sure as when I read it, with pretty watery eyes. So pretty amazing story. So I thought that was kind of cool to tell that. But thank you, Roy.
So if you get a chance, go on and try and get a copy of this book. Maybe Kitty can hold it up so people can see what it looks like from the cover. That's an awesome book. Again, here for our MAVTV cameras, Medal of Honor.
stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch, and threadbare the bones bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still there.
How about us for the guys on the weekend? Right now we're doing motorcycles.